Former Kinango DCIO Veronica Gitahi and former police constable Issa Mzee, convicted of killing 14-year-old Kwekwe Mwandaza in Kwale, will spend 2 days in custody before they know their actual sentence on Monday. High Court Judge Martin Muya postponed the judgment pending scrutiny of mitigation presented before him and the compensation scheme pressed by the victim's lawyers. Haron Ndubi, representing Kwekwe's family, cited the Victims Protection Act 2014 that allows those aggrieved to seek compensation. Tension was palpable in the courtroom as friends and relatives of the two gathered to listen to the final determination. The late Kwekwe Mwandaza was killed in cold blood in August 22, 2014, when police stormed their home in search of a murder suspect. The case has continued to attract attention from several quarters, with some human rights organizations petitioning for its conclusive determination.
Passed in November 2014, a victim of crime, whether it is theft or injury or any type of crime, is entitled to be compensated for the loss incurred. And that law also, such loss includes expenses associated with the trial of that case. And this compensation is usually awarded after conviction of the accused person.
All right, let's now join our reporter Francis Ontomwa, who is in Mombasa. Francis, have you been able to speak to the family and friends of Kwekwe Mwandaza, and what's their feeling on the proceedings today?
Hello, good afternoon, Michelle Ngele. And yes, it has been a day that many were waiting to know which way this particular case was going to take. And the family actually left the court a bit disappointed, because today they wanted to know how many years the two would have been sentenced. And this would perhaps ended this long wait that has characterized this case. This case has lasted for 2 years, you remember, since Kwekwe Mwandaza was killed. Well, today, actually, what transpired is actually a postponement of this determination, which will be made Monday by High Court Judge Martin Muya. And this is explained by two facts. The defense actually tried to mitigate this particular sentence, to try and make it, to try and plea for a pardon for the two suspects. Jared Magolo, the lawyer for the defense, was actually trying to express how the two were remorseful on this particular occurrence. They actually, in his own words, he said that they had reflected and they were completely rehabilitated, and they needed to be pardoned of these two cases. Actually, he went ahead to give a bit of details about these two officers. He said that Veronica Gitahi was a single mother of three and was also diabetic, some of the reasons that he tried to give the court for the pardon. Issa Mzee is a father of two, and his wife is not employed, some of the reasons that Jared Magolo tried to convince the court. The victim's lawyer, Haron Ndubi, was also categorical that they needed to compensate the family of Kwekwe Mwandaza. They said that the family had spent a lot of money on the expenses of the trial and also the burial, and you remember the exhumation, the high-profile exhumation that was much publicized by the media. These are some of the reasons that the two lawyers were trying to argue from either side, and this could have prompted why Martin Muya, the High Court judge, postpone this case to be determined Monday, Michelle.
All right, now Francis, the two have of course argued as to why they should not be held culpable for this, but what are the police there saying? Are they holding these two to account on what they did?
Well, of course, this case is all about trying to hold account the two police officers what transpired. There is of course public outrage on the developments of the 22nd day of August 2014 when this happened. There is a lot of public outrage, and this case is trying really to determine which way justice is going to take. Well, something very important to note is the fact that you remember that when Kwekwe Mwandaza was killed, he was buried actually the next day, and this was all, according to the court, it was all a scheme of trying to conceal important information that could have prosecuted this particular case. A second post-mortem had to be conducted, and this was petitioned by the family, and it occasioned the exhumation of the body of Kwekwe Mwandaza. And actually, it was determined later on that Kwekwe Mwandaza by a high-velocity bullet that could have come from a G3 or an AK-47. Of course, contrary to claims earlier that she had died through a pistol, meaning that it was close range. of course, trying to cement the fact that they wanted to paint the girl as a visual attacker, wanted to attack the police. Well, these are some of the things that many have questioned. The court has already put to test some of these arguments, and Monday, the fate of which way the two police officers will be sentenced will be known by then Monday.
All right, thank you very much, Francis Ontoma, there from Mombasa. We'll be keeping you up to date with that story in our subsequent bulletins.